Hello students, today we are going to learn a new lesson from our English course book. The name of the lesson is The Canterville Ghost. Let's see what are we all going to learn today. To identify the feature that comprises a play, to recognize the humor in the play, identify phrases and clauses. The Canterville Ghost is a story written by Oscar Wilde. Now, let's look more about the author. Oscar Wilde was born on 16th October 1854 in Ireland. He was an Irish writer and poet. After writing in different forms through the 1880s, he became one of London's most popular playwrights in the early 1980s. He is widely remembered for his witty comments, his epigrams, and his brilliant plays. So today we are going to read a famous play written by Oscar Wilde. And the name of that play is The Canterville Ghost. Now, let's read more about the story. The story is about a ghost which lives in a house. The ghost tries to scare everybody who lives in the house. He loves doing this. But everything changes when a family from America decided to live in the house. The family already knows that there is a ghost in the house, but they do not believe in ghost. The ghost play many tricks to scare the family, but they don't work. He thinks the family will get scared of him and will move out from the house. But he failed. So, let's see what we are going to learn and what we are going to experience more about the ghost and his activities. We can just go through some words which you may feel a little bit difficult. Mansion. It's a noun, a large, impressive. Insist. It's a verb. Demand something forcefully, not accepting refusal. She insisted on carrying her own bag. Duchess. It's a noun. The wife or widow of a duke. A woman holding a rank equivalent to duke in her own right. The next word is sobbing. It's an adjective. Crying noisily. Clara collapsed in a sobbing heap at the feet of other girls. The next word, faints. It's a verb. Lose consciousness for a short time because of a temporarily insufficient supply of oxygen to the brain. One example, I fainted from the loss of blood. The similar meaning of the word fainted is pass out. Skeleton. It's a noun. An internal or external framework of bone, cartilage or other rigid material supporting or containing the body of animal or plant. The human skeleton. In the background you can see the picture. So it helped to understand the meaning of the word easily. We can also use the skeleton for the supporting framework, basic structure or essential part of something. The concrete skeleton of an unfinished building. Similar meaning of that word is framework. So, we are moving on to the lesson The Canterville Ghost written by Oscar Wilde. We can first of all look who are the main characters of this play. You can see the characters is given in your textbook on page number 26. Lord Canterville, Mr. and Mrs. Otis, Miss Omni, Washington, Virginia, the twins, the ghost. They are the important characters of this play. Now let's move on to our lesson, The Canterville Ghost by Oscar Wilde. The Canterville Ghost is a well-known short story by Oscar Wilde. It is a ghost story with a difference. Instead of fear and tension, humor rules the story. The humans are not afraid and the ghost struggles to scare them. So far, no one had insulted the clever ghost in this way. The ghost had finally met its match in this spirited, bold American family. Frightening them seemed almost impossible. Let's read scene 1. At the Canterville Chase. Lord Canterville, I am really pleased you want to buy Canterville Chase, but there is something you have to know. If you insist, Lord Canterville. Yes, I do. There is this ghost in. Mr. Otis, a ghost? Do you talk about it? Lord Canterville, I fear the ghost exists. I think you should listen to our family story. Mr. Otis, try me. Lord Canterville, I will tell you what happened to my grand aunt, the Dowager Duchess of Bolton. The side of the stage where Mr. Otis and Lord Canterville are standing is darkened, and the other side is lit up. Sounds of a woman screaming are heard. The butler and the housekeeper lead the Duchess to a chair and give her a drink of water. She sits down terrified. Duchess, please don't leave me alone here. Take me away from here. Screams. Get away from me. Don't touch me. The housekeeper. My lady, come down. There is nobody here. Look around you. Duchess, sobbing. That thing. It had its bony hands on me. I didn't notice at first. I thought it was a cold draught. Then I saw those skeleton hands. The Duchess screams again and faints. The side where Mr. Otis and Lord Canterville are standing is lit up. Lord Canterville, my grand aunt was so frightened that she never recovered from the shock. Mr. Otis, and you want me to believe this? Lord Canterville, Mr. Otis, the ghost has been seen by several members of my family. After the unfortunate accident to the Duchess, none of our younger staff would stay with us. Mr. Otis, well, we came from a modern country. We do want, we want. We have money and everything that money can buy. Lord Canterville, what is your point? Mr. Otis, my dear Lord, we would buy the ghost itself. If there were such a thing and a place, it in the museum for its worth. Lord Canterville, if you don't mind a ghost in your house, it's quite all right with me. But let me tell you one last time. The ghost has been around for 3 centuries. And it always make its appearance before the death of a family member. Mr. Otis, guffawing. Well, so does the family doctor, Lord Canterville? Lord Canterville, with a knowing smile. All right, Canterville. Chase is all yours. So here we are going to stop. In scene number 1, we can see the entry of Otis family to the Canterville Ghost and the conversation between Lord Canterville and Mr. Otis. Mr. Otis is not ready to believe what Lord Canterville is telling him. So let's see what happened to them in the coming classes. Now I'm going to ask you a few questions. Listen carefully to check whether you have comprehend the paragraph or not. Some questions are given here. Try to find answer for these questions. If you cannot find answer for this question, don't feel bad. Read it again. I'm sure you all will be able to answer these questions. Now let's move on to the grammar section. Today we are going to learn about phrases and clauses. We know that phrases and clauses are a part of a sentence. So let's look what is a phrase at first. A group of related words used with a subject, a predicate, or both. Hiding under the table. The dog knew he was bad. Here, the highlighted part is phrase. You can see a subject and a predicate there. Mickey Mouse, the world's best enemy character, enraged the student. The world's best enemy character. It's a phrase here. So, as we already have mentioned, a phrase is a group of words that make sense together. It is called phrase. A phrase does not have a verb of its own and therefore does not complete the meaning. The meaning of the sentence will not be completed because the phrase is not having a verb. What is a clause? A clause is a group of words that has a verb. It can be part of a sentence or be a sentence itself. A clause has a subject and a predicate of its own. One example is given here. I jumped into the pool, though I could not swim. Here, I jumped into the pool is the clause. In that sentence, we can see a subject, a verb, and a predicate. So, a clause may be a part of a sentence or a sentence completely. In our textbook, an activity is given there. Check page number 34 and you have to write whether the highlighted words are phrases or clauses. We will be doing more examples of this during our class. Hope you all understand today's class. Have a nice day. Thank you.